Hello everyone and welcome to Python India Mega Meetup September 2020. Today I will be talking about contributing to core Python development. So this is a beginner level guide to get you started with the core contribution towards core Python project. So let's get started. So let me introduce myself. My name is Abhijit Kasurde. I work for Ansible. I'm a free and open source evangelist. So if you want to contact me, you can contact me through GitHub and Twitter. The IDs are given below. So what is the agenda for today's talk? So first of all, we will start with finding the issues. Then we will go through the community help guidelines. Then we will see the actual contribution process. And then we will see example of the contribution process that I followed for one of my issues, and some useful links for further reading. So first of all, in order to get started with the contribution towards any open source project, you need to find the issues that are tracked by that project. So first of all, you can find the issues using the bug tracker that the project uses. In this case, Python core Python uses bugs.python.org. So it looks like this. So here I have logged in using my account, and you can see that bugs.python.org is the place where every bug related to Python is tracked. So this is the basic list of issues that are presented over here. So the web UI presented over here is very simple and clean. You will get a clear idea of the bug ID, then you will get information about the activity, the title of the issue, status, the reporter's name, the issue assigned to, and the type of the issues and messages related to that. So over here you will see that there are two icons. One is related to GitHub and one paperclip. These two icons shows that it has patches or PRs related to them. So this is very clean and easy to access UI, so that you can go through the things and start debugging the stuff. So whenever you feel that you have encountered an issue, the main idea is that you come here and first search about the issue that you are encountering. So if you find something, you better add comments into the issues comment section stating that I am also facing the same issues with so and so Python release, so and so operating version, and so and so are the reproducing steps. So this is very clean UI. As you can see at the bottom of this screen, you will see that there are you can sort these issues according to the various properties of the issues, and also group them depending upon the properties of the issues. So whenever you start with any open source project, or when you start with the core Python development, you might want to start with the easy fixes. So this bug tracker gives you already pre-filled query to search easy fixes. So at the summaries section, if you click on this easy issues icon, you will be presented with the list of issues. So it will present you various issues which are easy to fix or low hanging fruits. So here you can see the ID, activity, title, status, and the reporter's name. So if you can go through the list of these things, and as per your liking, you can start working on that. You can see that there are some documentation related issues, some of them are code related issues, and some of them are test related issues. So depending upon your liking, you may want to scan these issues and start debugging them. Even if the issues are having PRs, you might want to tackle these issues with your own understanding. So you may want to take the implementation of the existing fix and might want to start with your own logic behind that fixing. So that way your Python skills will improve, as well as you might get into a better solution that is available already over here. Okay. So then there is another site called as Code Triage. So Code Triage is a website which provides an easy way to start with the open source projects. So here I have added the query for C Python, Python. So that's why it has produced this list of the issues. So you can go through these issues, and it says that it needs help. So it also segregates them according to the docs and these things. So Code Triage is very important, or you may say helpful website to find issues related to Core Python or any other open source project. Yeah. So once you have finalized your issue that you want to tackle in while getting started with the development process, you might end up in getting some information about the project. So community is the answer to this question. So whenever you are stuck in anywhere, you might want to ask some questions to the community or the fellow developers. So Python Core project host IRC channel at irc.freenode.net, and the channel name is python-dev. So this channel is very specific to Python development. You might want to ask Python development related issues on this channel and not the Python related issues. So if you feel that the IRC is not good communication channel for you, you might want to try mailing list for Python development. So the mailing list is listed over here. You might want to visit this mailing list. The mailing list is hosted here, mail.python.org, and you want to create an account for the subscription and subscribe to this mailing list. You might want to see the older issues as well. You can go through these archives. So these archives are threaded by the months. So if you are looking for any older issues or older mails, you might want to go through this list of months. So you can also segregate the mailing list according to these tags, like most active, most popular. If you are looking for something specific, you might want to search it over here. So it will present you all the related things which are available to this thing. So whatever this keyword is present in this search criteria, it will present all the mails which are mentioning this thing. Yeah. So mailing list is another way of communicating to the fellow developers. So while going through the debugging steps, you might want to go through the development guidelines as well. So this is the website that I followed for getting the help for developing the Python skills. So here it's a very good site that will guide you to every little things that are required for Python development. So like I said, the IRC channel, then mailing list and everything. So once you have gone through this documentation, you are ready for your next step. So you might think like how you can contribute towards the community or towards the Python Core project. So you can contribute to the Python code community by providing the code. So you can write the code for the given issues, or you can write new features or new implementation of the existing problems. Then you can design various algorithms or workflows, or depending upon what things are available, you can design things. Then you can always provide ideas, different ideas, so that fellow developers might want to take that idea and take it forward and implement those ideas in the given scenario. then if you are okay in doing documentation related stuff, then you can always help to contribute documentation, because whenever any community is growing and newcomers are coming into the community, they want to first go through the documentation, and if the documentation is good, then they will contribute more. So documentation plays an important part in any process, software development process or any open source project. Then then comes the part of tests. So if you are interested in doing QA or doing the quality assurance for your Python core project, so you might want to contribute the test cases or write test cases or fix the existing test cases or expand these test cases to cover more code so that it does not fail for it does not regret or regress or do something related to that. Yeah, another way of contributing is to support by means is you can always use the software, you can use the Python latest bits of Python, try it on your various hardwares like x86, 64, then you can try it on ARM and try to reproduce the bugs which are already filed in the bugs tracker, and then provide your valuable feedback to the issues that are available in the issue tracker. Like if you take one issue and try to reproduce on the specific hardware, specific configuration that you have, and tell them that this is generating the issues on the given platform, or you can always say like this is not reproducible, can you provide some more information, something like that. So that is also adds value to the project, because you are providing some valuable information for the reporter as well as the fixer who is going to fix that issue. Yeah. So these are the different ways by which you can contribute to the community. Yeah. So coming back to the process, so I contributed to Core Python by means of providing a code. So first of all, I will like to introduce to this bug. So as you know, I work in Ansible community. So this was filed against Ansible repository. The issue says that this function is not implemented and using Python 3.5 and the VMware ESXi. So this issue seems to be related to Python version 3.5 and not to the Ansible version. So I looked into the code, I tried to reproduce the things, and I was able to reproduce the things which are provided by the original reporter. So this was the error that I was getting. So that's how I started the journey of contributing to core projects. So after a long discussion over here, we decided that it is a core Python issue, and then we have to fix it upstream before we can submit it to the actual Ansible or actual reproducer. So I went ahead and searched the issue over here. So I typed several keywords from the things, and I was not able to find the similar issue in the given repository. So I went ahead and filed this issue. So filing an issue is very important, because it provides a valuable information to the reproducers and the bug fixers, like the coders which are fixing these issues. So you can go through the guidelines which are provided for filing the issues. So in order to create issue, you can click this link. So after creating this issue, you can see that there is a title. You have to provide a concise title, that default selector fails to detect the selector on VMware ESXi. So I have provided a component library. Then I have provided the version, that is the Python 3.5. So right now this issue is closed because I have fixed it. So the resolution is fixed and the status is closed. So I provided the comments like this fails on the VMware ESXi. I have provided the minimum reproducible steps so that anybody from the community can take these steps and reproduce them as per their environment. And then I have added some debugging things as well. Like I found that default selector mechanism for select implementation is not available for default selector. So after that, I was waiting for community to answer. So I've done my follow up as well. Like so whenever you don't get any attention on in any issues, it is better practice that that you should do the follow up for that issue. So like pinging like any news or any further steps need to be done or something like that, so that people will get to know that there is a issue and they might want to take a look into that. So once I have filed the issue, I started my debugging on my site. So I went to the CPython repo. So first thing I did was I did fork for this repo. So I have already forked this repo. So I have my own repo over here. So I did my fork over here and started working on that issue. So I cloned this repo in my local repository, local laptop, and created one branch. It is good practice to create branches and do the testing and do the development on those branches so that you can switch to other branches and do the stuff related to that. So you can simultaneously work on multiple things. So like that. Yeah. So I created the clone and on the local repository. Then I created branch as well. So the branch is not available, I guess. I have deleted that branch. I started debugging things like a normal thing, and then came up with the implementation of that in the Ansible first. Then I realized that this issue needs to be fixed in the upstream version as well. So I fixed it in the upstream repository first. So let me find that link first. So this is the commit ID. Yeah. So this is the PR that I have created. So once I have done the full testing and all that, I filed the issue. So I have provided a small title to this. So this is basically bugs.python.org. It is coming from this. So this is the requirement that you should name your pull request something like this: BPO hyphen the name of the number of the issue. So you can cross check directly to this issue. So if you check out the number as well, so this is issue 4411 41182. So this is that, so that everybody else can directly map this issue to the issue tracker. And this is the simple title given to this pull request. So here I have added some description, small description about the fix I am providing. So this was the problem. Some platforms does not detect, and I have also provided the fix description here, that this fix adds the check and all that. Then over here I have added the number of fix, the issue number as well, and this is the sign off. So whenever you do Python core Python development, you need to sign the CLA. So this CLA, you need to sign it. So if you go in the documentation itself, it provides a good documentation how you have to do the CLA signing process. So let me find it. So you might want to go through his documentation to find out whether you have signed the CLAs or not. So this documentation give good provides documentation related to contributor license agreement. So before contributing to core Python repository, you need to sign that CLA. So since I have signed a CLA, it shows that CLA is signed. So all these workflows are maintained by the bots, so you don't have to do anything. So I received couple of comments, and then after some discussion, I modified the patch and I pinged the requested core maintainers of Python that this is needs to be reviewed again, and then I got approval from several people, and you might want to see the names as well. Then since this was affecting multiple branches, I requested to backport this change to 3.9 as well. So this got backported to the older versions as well. So that's how I fixed the core Python related issue. You might want to check the process which is provided here. So after coming to this process is very well documented under this documentation guide. So it gives you quick references how to do that, how to, so after cloning what needs to be done, how you can run the test cases, how you need to check out things, then what is the naming criteria, how do you create a pull request, what are the status of Python branches and all that. So it gives you a lot of information about the coverage and how to contribute to the things. So this is the process that I followed, and I was fortunate enough so that I got my patch merged into the core Python. So after going through this process, you might want to do what next? So there are multiple branches that you can follow. So in the new contributors guide, you can follow these steps, like you can get the help, follow the lifecycle pull request. So these are the documentation related to new contributors. Then if you are interested in documentation, you can help creating good documentation, style guide, restructured primers, translating things and documenting various scenarios, give examples and all that. If you are interested in triaging issues, then you can always do the issue triaging. Issue triaging is nothing but like reproducing things, asking whether the issue is correct or not. These kind of things can be done by the issue tracker. So I'll give you one example of the issues. So if I go bugs.python.org over here, you will see that. So let's assume that I want to debug some issue. So here you will see that this issue is filed yesterday and it has a short name. So if I click on this, you will see that there are several problems over here, that there is no title which is stating the correct information, there is no version selected. So you might want to cross-check the details provided by the reporter. And since this is a pending, it is requested to the reporter that they should provide the more information. So this is the task of issue triager. So once you are good with this thing, you can go through the help and find the things for your triaging stuff. Then if you are interested in becoming the core developer, this is the guidelines that you should follow. That what is the development cycle, how the pull requests are accepted, developer logs, then how to become a core developer for Python. So it gives you a brief overview what it takes and what does it mean, what privileges do you get, and like I said, it also helps you to provide information about the CLAs, what are the responsibilities of the core contributor. So you might want to go through this detailed information, and it will help you to contribute to the Python project. Yeah. So these are the some of the useful links that I have gathered. So this is one of the interesting guide that I found while researching this thing. So this helps you not just contribute to the core Python project, but overall to the open source project. So this gives you good information about how to get started, how to if you don't know, how to ask questions and all these kind of things. So this is very good guide for going through the things. Then there is a there are other issue developer guides as well. I have linked over here. You might want to get into those links as well. So I would like to thank these contributors for providing the images that are used in this slides. I have taken it from the Unsplash site, and thank you. We hope that you like this presentation and take the tips from this slides and go forward and start contributing to Python or any other open source project in general. Yeah, thank you.